In the name of God, in this illustration, we intend to simulate the consolidated undrained triaxial test in the Abaqus software. In the left picture, you observed the geometric shape of soil in which the soil has been considered as a cylindrical shape with a diameter of 5 cm and height of 5 cm. In the right picture, you can see the triaxial test apparatus. Actually, we intend to simulate the example 5.7 from Sam Helwani book in the Abaqus software. I'll enter the Abaqus software for simulation. First, I'll open the model of the consolidated drained triaxial test. Here, you should first watch this film and after that, observe training in continuation. Here, we should create series of changes on the model so that the model of consolidated drained triaxial test would be converted into the consolidated undrained triaxial test. As explained in Sam Helwani book, there are two differences between consolidated drained triaxial test and consolidated undrained triaxial test. And here, these two differences can be clearly observed. The first difference is that the top and bottom surfaces of the soil are impervious in consolidated undrained triaxial test model, so that the possibility of drained from these two surfaces would not be provided. To do so, I will enter the Abaqus software, enter the load module, click on Boundary Condition Manager. Here you can observe the boundary condition of the pore water pressure. Here I will click on Deactivated in Shearing Step. In this manner, the possibility of drainage from the top and bottom surfaces of the soil would not be provided. The second difference is that the shearing load is applied faster. Actually, the high speed in loading indicates that the question is done in an undrained manner and pore water pressure will be created in the model. As explained in the book, the time period is equal to 100 seconds. I will enter step module, click on step manager, then on edit and enter the time period as 100 seconds. Here, I will enter initial increment size as 10. And here, maximum pore pressure change per increment as 0.7 kilopascal. That is 0.7. multiplied by 10 to the power of 3 Pascal. Click on OK. In the next step, I'll enter load module. Here, the quantity of displacement is equal to 0.127 centimeter. Well, I'll click on Boundary Condition Manager. Here, click on Edit and enter the quantity of negative 0.127 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 2 meter and OK. In the next step, I'll enter job module here, click on create. Continue, OK, and submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I'll click on result. Here you can observe the formation of the soil. The simulation is aimed at drawing this diagram that you can observe here. Here the vertical axis deviator stress and the horizontal axis constitute the axial strain. To draw this diagram, I will click on create XY data. From here select ODB field output and continue. From here select unique nodal, then S11 and S22 from this part. Then click on edit selection, select this node. This node is just in the center of the soil. Then I click on save and OK. In this manner. In the next step, I click on create XY data, then on operate on XY data and continue. I will subtract this diagram from this one and click on plot, save, and OK. In the next step, I click on create XY data. From here on operate on XY data and continue. I'll then select this diagram and divide that by 1000 and save as that. In this manner, the unit of stress will be turned to kilopascal, so I click on OK, as you observe here. In the next step, I'll click on create XY data, from here on ODB field output, and continue. In the next step, I will select axial strain in Y direction from here, and node from this part, and click on plot, in this manner. Then save as that, and OK, which you can observe here. Here I will click on create XY data, select operate on XY data and continue. Here I will select combine. First select axial strain, then deviator stress and click on plot. In the next step I will put a negative sign here, click on plot again, save as that. And OK, in this manner. Here I will right click on the final diagram, edit, select these two columns, copy and paste them in Excel software. The first column is the axial strain. And the second column is deviator stress. Well, I will select these two columns. Select this diagram from the Insert menu. Here, the diagram drawn in blue is the one having been gained from the Abaqus software. As you observe, the diagram results having been gained from the Abaqus software are quite the same as those in some Helvani book. In the next step, we'll intend to draw this diagram. The vertical axis is the excess pore water pressure, and the horizontal axis is the axial strain. I'll click on Create XY Data in order to draw this diagram. From here, ODB field output, continue. Then select pore pressure from here, select this node, click on Plot, Save, and OK. In the next step, I will click on Create XY Data, then on Operate on XY Data, and Continue. Here, I will select this diagram and divide that by 1000 and Save As. In this manner, the unit of pore pressure will be turned to kilopascal. Then we'll click on OK. In the next step, I'll click on Create XY Data. From here on, Operate on XY Data and Continue. Here I will select Combine. First I will select axial strain, then pore pressure, and click on Plot. In the next step, I'll put a negative sign here, then click on Plot, Save as that, and OK. Here I will right click on this diagram, select these two columns, copy and paste them in Excel software. The first column is the axial strain. And the second one is the pore water pressure. Here I will select these two columns and select this diagram from Insert menu. The diagram in blue is the one having been gained from the Abaqus software. As you observe here, the results having been gained from the Abaqus software are quite the same as those in some Helvani book.